just go in the studio, and when it comes to production, we're just like, what's going to be the weirdest thing that we've ever heard, and what's going to be something that no one has ever done before? So we arrived on something that we called Spokestep. We would take vocals, put them on the sample machine there, and
create a beat, basically, with the vocals.
We were thinking, let's write five or however many songs are on the EP, five songs that have concepts that no one has ever talked about before in music. And a couple examples, like our song, I'm Not Famous. Everyone talks about, I'm so famous and I have this amount of money, but no one really has ever talked about why it's so great to not be famous, why you can just be your weird self on the street.
Each song, I think we tackle a different topic, and like Weak is another example. We're kind of surrounded by songs about staying strong and confident, and that's good, but that's sometimes an unrealistic expectation to set for the general, you know, population. And so we wanted to write a song about being faced with temptation and actually giving in and being weak and being human.
No thank you is what I should have said. I should be in bed, but temptations of trouble on my tongue, trouble's yet to come.
It was it
bad for me,
one hit,
bad for me,
one kiss,
bad for me, but I gave it so easily, and no thank you is how it should have gone. I should stay strong, but
it has to do with street performing, where we were raised with this mentality of trying to catch people's attention.
You go out there and you just have a microphone and like a tiny little speaker. Nobody's there to see you. You have to kind of work your performing chops and put on a show to make people stop what they're doing during the day. Doing that, we made enough money to buy a ukulele, to buy our whole Pro Tools setup, and to buy a microphone, and that's how we kind of got started.
Something clicked at a certain moment, and we stopped fronting. You know, we stopped trying to act cooler than we actually were in real life, and I think that that's an easy trap to fall into for a new artist, to act way cooler than you are in real life. And at some point, we just like clicked, and we just became our nerdy, weird selves on stage.
And now that we found something that we feel works and we can connect to, and we see that fans connect to too, we're in the process of writing the album that kind of has this similar feeling to what everyone's thinking, where each song is something different that you haven't heard about in pop music before.
Aside from being the biggest artist out there and being able to sell the most tickets, what's really important is continuing to move the industry forward, because that's the way music is really going to survive. So if in 5 years or whatever we could have created the new sound at the time, like someone like Lorde or Macklemore or whatever,
Kanye
yeah. did, I think that's just the greatest goal that we have in mind.
I should say so, but I'm weak, and what's wrong?
Listening to our music, just don't care what anyone else thinks about you. We write all these songs that are just really self-deprecating, and it's just because it's all true. And it's because at some point in our life, we kind of stopped caring what people thought about us, and we just wrote about what we felt like, and we've never felt better.
Try and figure out the music that you like, separate from society, separate from who's big at the moment. kind of figure out what you really are passionate about and just like that despite what anybody thinks of you.